Hi, let's talk about the palpebrae, or the eyelids. The palpebrae surround the palpebral fissure, which is the open space through which the eyes make gaze. There is a superior palpebra and an inferior palpebra, and where they meet at the edges are the canthi, or the angles. So there is a medial angle or canthus of the eye, and that is the direction to which tears drain. And there is a lateral angle or canthus of the eye. The palpebrae are variously layered, and within the palpebrae we find the tarsofacial layer. The tarsofacial layer of the orbit has many different facets to it, one of which is the extension of the periosteum. So we can see there's the frontal bone. That periosteum extends as the orbital septum. This orbital septum is going to separate the contents of the orbit from the palpebrae. That orbital septum is going to blend into the tarsal plates, or the tarsi. So there's the superior tarsus, and then there's the inferior tarsus. These tarsi give rigid support and shape to the eyelids. So if you've ever been around a child who wickedly turns their upper eyelids inside out, you can often make out the shape of the superior tarsus, and it's that superior tarsus which enables one to turn their eyelids inside out. The lateral edges of the orbit anchor to the palpebrae via palpebral ligaments. So for instance, both to the superior and the inferior alike, we have lateral palpebral ligaments and medial palpebral ligaments. That medial palpebral ligament is at the medial canthus of the eye, and it is also just anterior to the lacrimal sac, which serves as a not just a conveyance for tears, but it provides a vacuum for them to draw them across the conjunctival sac as part of the lacrimal apparatus. So we've discussed the palpebrae and the tarsofacial layer within the palpebrae. Thank you very much for your time.